Good morning, everybody. So today I have to upgrade my Dora bag. So I know that Mama Llama went over her Dora bag, and so I figured this would be a great time to kind of go over what I have and everything with you guys. So this is my Dora bag I had before, just a little backpack I think I got from Walmart. It worked great. I just ran out of space. So, and it was cool, like it has little straps with clips on that I was able to clip my gloves and clippers on, but it's just time to get a bigger one. So now I'm going to a camel bag. So, which is nice because then you don't have to worry about bringing a water bottle or anything, it's right there on your back. So I have all sorts of stuff on my couch over here you can't see. So we're going to start off with my books that I'm going to put in my new pack. So this is one of my favorite books ever. It's by Scott Kulos, and he had this, he doesn't exactly make them, but whoever published this book makes books for, like, every region, and so my mom has one for the mountain region that she lives in, but it's a great book. If you live in the Pacific Northwest with me, I would definitely look into this book. So it's always good to have an identification book to kind of help you if you don't remember exactly, and sometimes there's so many plants that are so close together, it's always best just to double check with yourself. Even if you're pretty sure, just double check. So the next books that I have, they're from the Herbal Academy when I went through and did the foraging course. These came with the course. So the first little book that they came with is a record keeping book. So this is always a great idea. It doesn't have to be exactly like this, but just something so you can remember, kind of refresh your memory. It tells you, like, has this little sheet that you can fill out about the common name, the names, the date you harvested it, the time, the weather conditions during harvesting, the location, characteristics, how you harvested it, methods that you harvested it, and even like your weights, how much it was when it was fresh, how much it was when it was dried. That way you can kind of figure out if you like lost some someplace or how much water was in it. And then there's a spot on the bottom you can keep your batch number. So if for some reason, like, let's say a bark that you got didn't quite work the way that you wanted it to, you can kind of go back and see when you harvested it, what time of the year it was, and where it was at. And maybe it was something in the process that you accidentally let it not dry enough or something, and the oils couldn't come out. And then you can always keep a sketch of it. So then you can look back and realize what it looked like during that time of year. Did it have flowers? Did it not have flowers? Did it have just a couple of leaves? And you can kind of keep track of your harvest that way. And then they sent a little guidebook too. This is a nice little starter guidebook, but it doesn't really have pictures of anything, so it just has, like, the herbs and then the scientific names, which is always nice, but if you need something to kind of refresh your memory, I would definitely get one with pictures. It just makes it easier. And then it has, like, when to harvest what, time of year, how to harvest it, kind of how to process it, just some refreshers. And then in the back, it kind of breaks down those herbs they mentioned in the front a little bit with a tiny bit of pictures, but still not many. So this is also a great little book. So here comes all the fun parts. So I also have the little survival first aid kit that Mama Llama had. This kit is great. I know she kind of went over it with you, everybody, but it has everything that you could think or want you would need inside of it. I tore it all apart one day, and it took me like 2 hours figuring out how to put it back together. So I'm not going to take all of it out, but like, it has flint and steel in here for you. Has every like first aid type of kit thing you would need. Even has this little pocket utility tool, like if you have your car breaks down or something, you have a little bit of something to be able to help you. And then it has a little book. Again, I love little books to kind of help you walk through if you don't know first day too well or just need a refresher again. Refreshers never hurt anybody. Let's see if I can get this all back to close now. Alright. And then I have two types of clippers. So I have big old clippers if I'm trying to clip like twigs and stuff off willow trees or even off aspens and stuff to collect the bark. And then I have smaller clippers for flowers, yarrow, any little things that I come across. I try and use these ones more just because it's easier to handle. But I just got these brand new ones and I love the lock. So you just squeeze it and it comes apart. You don't have to try and fight with it. And then you just push it closed. But it's nice because whenever you pop the lock open, you can actually stick it back up inside whenever for your work in. But I would definitely recommend getting scissors and shears that have locks. Just for safety reasons, when you're digging around in your bag looking for stuff, you don't cut your finger out in the woods, open yourself up for infections. Never a good thing. Safety comes number one. Alright, and then I have Ziploc bags galore. So I always love to try and keep everything separated. Does that always happen? No, but you know, I try. So I have a couple of different size baggies. These ones we got our herbs in, and so they're just super thick, nice, resealable bags that I try and reuse instead of just throwing them away. So I have all these in there. And then again, I have a little wad of random Ziploc baggies that I had herbs in that I don't want to just toss. I'll get these all wadded up, stick them in here someplace. And then always string is always nice. If you run out of Ziploc bags or just happen to forget them, you can always tie your herbs together or your twigs. I can't tell you how many times I've thrown like branches of pine in my car and then the next day I have pine everywhere. So tie them together. Then that way you can just grab the little bundle and just run. And it's always funny to watch, you know, Willow try and play with them. So the next thing I have is a pocket knife. This one is kind of on the larger side. But again, locks closed and open so you don't hurt yourself trying to harvest. You can use these for mushrooms. Again, any type of like twig or anything that you need. Just be careful. Don't cut yourself. Again, safety is number one. Let's see if I can get this in there. All right, and then flashlights. You can never have too many flashlights, ever. You never know when you're going to accidentally be out longer than you thought. So you always want to find your way back. And then a compass. It's always a great idea to have a compass. This one has the string so you can pick. It's kind of hard to see. Oh, there you are. That way you can pick landmarks and make sure you're going in a straight line. So if you accidentally get turned around, the sun goes down and you can't see where the sun is at, you can always find your way back to your car. Because you never want to be stuck out too late. And then I have a little spray bottle of rubbing alcohol. So this isn't a necessity, but I definitely recommend it. That way you can spray your shears between harvesting, just to kind of make sure that there's no cross-contamination of oils from the plants. Mushrooms, you want to make sure that you spray them first, because they have a lot of the spores and things that come off onto your shears, and then you'll be spreading the spores onto whatever else you harvest afterwards. So if people are allergic to them or things like that, you want to make sure that you clean it with rubbing alcohol first. And then one last thing, I have this cloth bag. It actually had rice in it, but it works perfect. So it has a little zippy on the top, so you can zip your herbs shut in it. You can put your bundles in there. You can just throw your Ziploc baggies in there if you have your Ziploc bags. Because it's cloth, it actually allows them to dry inside there a little bit. So whenever you get home, it's not like a mushy mess in the bottom of a bag. and then I always just clip it on a carabiner on my belt loop. And then as I'm going through the woods, I can just clip and harvest stuff and just throw it right in my bag. And then whenever I get home, I just grab my bag, go inside, and can go process all my herbs that I found. And this was an awesome little find. Can't really think of anything else that I put in my bags. A map is always great to have if you don't know the land you're going to for too well. Having like wax paper with crayons so you can always make a note to people if you're like leaving camp or something, if you're camping with other people, just to let them know where you're going, when you'll be back. Just communicate with people when you're going foraging. I know we never plan to be stuck out someplace, but it's always better to be safe than sorry. Just let people know and have fun. Go explore. Find new things. All right, you guys. Thank you so much. Have a great day, everybody.